today's unboxing is going to be a little bigger than usual. And also, we're going to get fully green today. So those of you who already know that green is my favorite color, this velvety dark green, will probably kind of know color could be inside this package. So I'm very thankful that they sent me the dark green version of the Huawei MateBook as you can already see. This is a notebook. The first notebook that I ever unbox on this channel. So, I just want to let you know that I'm not very good expert when it comes to notebooks, but I will give you all the specs and we'll look at the design and we're going to enjoy the great sounds that the MateBook X Pro provides. Okay, let's dive in and open that box up. It comes with a little handle over here. It's quite heavy. Thank you. Okay. Here we have the actual box of the Huawei. So the box has some kind of a very subtle texture to it. So I think over here is some kind of side for now, so we can dive in detail in a second. First of all, let's have a look at the rest of the box so we can just put it aside. So we have two compartments over here. I'll just open this one up with those little icons. I think it's some kind of instruction manual and stuff, and probably the charging cable. Seems to... no. Other side. Yeah, I was right. Here we have something that looks like an adapter. Yeah, it's an adapter. So this end, the USB type C end, goes into the MateBook. Oh, and then we have HDMI, another USB type C, probably if you want to connect your phone. And I'm kind of lacking the name of this one, but I think it's for some kind of screen, external screen connection. I think it's used for that. And on this side, we also have standard USB Type-A output, which is pretty nice that you get that with the MateBook already. I know different brands that will not give you these in the box with your new and very expensive notebook. Not to name something here, but still. Next thing in here be not very long. I don't know, probably long enough, but yeah, it could be longer sometimes if you don't have a power output somewhere in your reach. And as usual, some kind of paper stuff. And the second compartment is a lot smaller than the first one. Let me just get that out. So I think we all know what's in here. Has an output of 10 watt. 10. Seems a little bit low, doesn't it? Anyway. Was left in the box. And now let's get to the exciting part. Okay, first let us just get rid of this horrible extremely loud, so I just open it up and light it down on top. Okay, let's have a real first look. Here we are. This is the emerald green version of the Huawei MateBook X Pro. Screen size of nearly 14 inches, so it's 13.9 inches. So as you can see, it's pretty small, but it's perfect for on the go when you need to travel a lot. Very light, yeah, extremely light. If I compare it to my 15 inches MacBook Pro, this is extremely light. As I already said, I'm not a great expert at notebooks, but I do want to give you some specs so you know what we're talking about here. So, the CPU is an Intel i7-1050U, and the GPU is an NVIDIA MX250. So when it comes to the GPU, I was kinda interested if that will be enough for like very casual gaming. I love to play Sims 4. Really, I really do. I have like so many DLCs, and yeah, the more DLCs you have, the more power the game kind of needs. It feels like you have to have like a very good computer or a very reasonable computer to run that game with a lot of DLCs. And yeah, so I was interested if this GPU is good for like not the top-notch games, but like casual, and I don't know, Sims 4 on kind of high resolution options, but it seems as if that's not the best GPU for, yeah, very fluent gaming. So this might not be like the best kind of notebook if you are interested in gaming. But on a side note, that's not what the Huawei MateBook X Pro is aiming for. So this should be something if you want to work with your casual office applications and stuff like that. I think you could also run a lot of those very high end programs like the Adobe Suite and stuff like that on it. I think that should be fine. I haven't tested it yet, but I will. So we have CPU and GPU. We already know about that. So what about RAM and storage? So RAM is 16 gigabyte and storage is a 1 terabyte SSD. Okay, I know this is a very pretty color, but let's open it up, shall we? So here we go. We have some kind of plastic thing on top that tells us the most important things. So for example, here just jumps out if I push this button. So cool. And we have the power button with an inbuilt fingerprint reader. Also here and here on both sides is a USB Type-C port, and you can charge the MateBook with either of these. And here we have the keyboard. Oh, it feels really good. That could be a very good keyboard, actually. It gives you definitely enough feedback. And it's very, very smooth. Oh, that's so cool. And here we have the touchpad. Need a lot of pressure. Yeah, okay. It seems there is no kind of no kind of 3D touch. just like normal click, but it's very big. I think for the size of the notebook overall, this is very big. Something that I find very cool is that you have Huawei Share, because I'm using a Huawei phone. This is something that's actually very, very cool. Okay. Let me get you a little closer. Here